a little more overstated than you are. I mean, I thought that your costume would probably be more lavish than that which you appear to be wearing.
I'm overestimated.
By the world at large or by your public?
By everybody, I think, yes.
Well, how do you think you've received this overestimation? Why is your reputation inflated?
That's just a lyric from a song.
Oh, I do beg your pardon. I thought it was some sort of judgment you were making.
No.
But have you calmed yourself down in clothes over the years?
Try me.
I don't know quite how. Are you hearing what I say to you?
Mm-hmm.
You have, in fact. Let's pretend we haven't started this. In the past, and we have some photographs to prove it.
You do?
Oh, yes, we
Blackmail?
Well, I don't know. Black female, there's one of them, you see. That's rather kind of more lavish
really
than what
black.
You're wearing now.
Yes, you think so?
Yeah. And we have another one to follow that, which is... Well, that's you, of course, with your...
It's still black, isn't it?
With your hat. No, it isn't. There you are with fans and a lot of stuff on the top of your head. What is that on the top of your head?
That's Chloe. Karl Lagerfeld sitting on my...
Did you have a late night?
I couldn't say that.
Did you have a late night last night?
They have bleepers, don't they? No, no.
Where were you last night?
No, I haven't slept in 3 days.
That explains it. Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
No, your accent is a bit foreign. Oh dear.
Now, how shall I go around the back of this? I wonder. Have you been photographed recently?
Just now, no, right now. On television?
No, have you been photographed as a model recently?
Oh, no, no. Is that what it is? Yes. No, no, not recently. I think I'm homesick, maybe, right?
I think there's something... I don't know what's wrong with you. I think there's something... How would you like to be photographed tonight by a man called Patrick Litchfield?
Oh, I think we've just made a date.
Back there?
Uh-huh.
Has he promised to photograph you?
Uh-huh.
Well, in order that we may find out whether this is a promise or a threat from Patrick Litchfield, let's introduce Patrick Litchfield. Ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Litchfield. Good evening to you.
Hello, Russell.
She says that she's just met you.
Don't turn your back to me.
Well, oh.
He's got a...
She says... She's just met you behind there and that you've promised to photograph her. Now, you are... I'll move my chair a little bit back so that I'm looking at both of you. You're actually engaged at the moment in photographing the 100 most famous, most beautiful women in the world at this precise moment.
That's it.
How many of the 100 have you photographed?
Well, since she's just said what she said, I'm up to 99.
You mean she...
I get 100.
Well, she gets the last, doesn't she? Because, well, I would like to photograph her. I'd love to.
Had you heard of her before?
In fact, of course. Tonight. But we've, in fact, just made a date for Thursday next week in New York.
Oh, so you're jetting over there to do it?
And nobody else will work on Thanksgiving Day, so she's agreed to go.
So he's coming to see you?
Right.
Now get some rest before he comes over to see you.
As long as I don't eat the turkey.
Right, no, fine. Or the stuffing even.
You're going to make
a lot of enemies if you're going to photograph the 100 most beautiful women in the world.
I think I took her place.
Yeah, perhaps you did. You're the wrong guy. Let me take your snap.
Oh, he's doing it now. Look out, he's going to do it now. Do you want to do it now?
No, I won't do it now, actually, because I'd rather have a more relaxed...
I am.
I don't think she... if you relax her anymore, she'll slip off the chair and fall away. I don't know what
I can't help it.
I don't know where your head is. Darling, I do not know where your head is at this moment. I know it's on the top of your shoulders, but, I mean, it's like... Have you ever tried to climb the north face of the Eiger in high-heel shoes?
Edward Wimper.
Because trying to squeeze blood out of a stone at the moment, but no doubt she'll relax as you get along.
Fall out of the chair.
Yeah, that's right. Fall back on it now.
Help.
Are there any of the 99 women you've actually photographed, are any of those Miss Worlds? Was it ever such an appalling thing that...
I had a few... Yes, I did. Yes.
It's coming...
Don't eat him.
It's coming to life.
Now, stay still, because, you know, it's very difficult for me to watch out what you're going to do to him and for him to ask me questions. Yes, I had
that for a moment. Because also with us tonight, we have another photographer. This one has a more particular regard for the curves of the countryside than actually female anatomy. He's a very fine landscape photographer. But this photographer also has vigorous opinions about elegance and style. He says to be elegant, you have to wear gloves and perfume and makeup. And this person wears all three. He's 89 years old on Saturday. He's in our audience tonight. Welcome, Mr. Walton. Wearing makeup tonight.
Yes, very special for you. Oh, well, I was 40 years in that. 40 years, yes.
And how did you start in that?
Well, I started because exactly the same perfume, she notices the deterioration.
Are you wearing perfume? Can you smell her at all?
No, I've got my own body odour perfume.
Let's try and keep it on a slightly higher level, if we may.
No.
Are you wearing perfume at this
moment? No. I very seldom do wear
perfume. No, if you turn your back to me one more minute, really.
I have got to talk to this.
This has been going on too long already.
Well, it's only going to go on in about another 6 minutes, and you're going to have another little part of it soon.
Maybe I should go right now.
Don't go right now unless you really want to.
Well, don't turn your back on me anymore.
I can't look at you. Now, hold. Hold on, just a moment.
Move your chair back a bit or something.
Can you listen to what he is saying? Because he's talking about his perfume making.
I love it. I wear all four different kinds of perfume.
Are you wearing any perfume at this precise moment?
No.
Get the bouquet now.
Well, now wait a minute. Let me just ask you one question.
I'm wearing the ones from last night. I had four different perfumes on last night, and I still have them on.
Just allow me then to ask him one more question, then I will come back to you. Right? Hold on for one second. Mr. Poucher, to some distinction, is also you're a photographer, a mountaineer and a photographer. Women can get away with what they like. It's as if they were a uniform for men. Nevertheless, there are pioneers.
Well,
you're going to tell me why?
Because men always make the fashion for women, that's why.
Well, here is a man who makes fashions for women. He's called Tom Gilby. And he's a designer for men and for women. He's appalled by what he calls the rigidity and banality of men's fashions. Welcome, Tom Gilby.
Here he is.
But before that, tomorrow night in London's Wigmore Hall, Eric Fenby, the man who 50 years ago became the eyes and the hands of the blind, paralysed composer Delius, will be giving a rare performance of one of Delius' works with the cellist Julian Lloyd Webber. And then they will come here next Tuesday night to join us in the company of a most unexpected Delius fan by the name of Kate Bush, and I hope it's a slightly quieter evening next Tuesday. Until then, another song from Grace Jones, Love is the Drug. Off you go, Jones.
I became a model to fill up the space, to fill the time in between, going on auditions for acting jobs. I had very strange features, though, for Americans, you know. They're not used. Everyone thought I have a nose job, for example. You know, they expect it to look like this, you know, instead of like a trumpet nose. Big beep. So it was very strange, you know. They weren't used to that kind of face, so it was quite difficult. But I thought, you know, I started doing more photographic things, you see, and they were more used to black models on the runway doing this number, you know. And I was horrible at that, terrible. No one gave me the job for runway modeling at all. So it was really what happened. Couple of special photographers, I believe, just like Irving Penn, you know, I go in and he just like picked up on my face, you know, and thought that. So I started doing really incredible photographic things. In Europe in 3 months, you know, I was on like 4 covers at the same time. And in the States, it took like 2 years. You know what I mean? Because it was I felt a kind of...
Now one of the most versatile, extraordinary looking and startling figures in the flamboyant world of pop culture. She's Grace Jones, the American model, rock music singer and cabaret star who last night made her British stage debut at the Drury Lane Theatre in London.
She used to call it disco theatre, but now she calls it her one-man show. Grace Jones, a Jamaican who mostly works in New York, is a tall, startling Amazonian figure who is famous for her looks and lifestyle long before she became a heroine of the smarter rock set.
At one time I would think that I didn't want to do music, you know. I just wanted to do films or visuals, you know, theater and film. I never really thought that strong in music. But after a while the music gets in your blood, you know, and it's difficult, I think, just to say, forget the music, you know, just going to films like I had originally planned. And I think they both work very well together. I think they're even stronger combined.
I mean, when you first left Jamaica and moved to the States, did you imagine at all you'd end up like this? I mean, what were your ambitions in those days?
To be a teacher, a nurse or something.
Because you came from a fairly straightforward background in Jamaica, didn't you?
Yes. Still. Still straightforward. So you think the normal things. I think girls rather think of getting married, you know, getting married, having kids, or being a nurse, or a teacher, some kind of help, you know.
When you got to New York, what was your initial ambition then? To simply escape from Jamaica and that sort of lifestyle,
yes,
to enjoy yourself, to do what?
It was an escape, definitely.
Because for a long time, and you were obviously labelled as the disco queen or a disco queen.
Yeah, well, I hated always that label, you know. I hate labels anyway.
Do you hate disco as such still?
No, I wouldn't say. I hate what disco became, you know, the visual image. It was a rather cheap, you know. I mean, but I don't hate that. Oh no, that's still the heartbeat of music. You know?
Did the disco movement as a whole collapse or lose direction in America then, or became boring?
No,
or
it
what?
Evolved into something. It became something else, you know. We call it the one-man show because of all the. It's a sort of masculine side of me that's really performing when it's filmed, and there are quite a bit of clones. Most of the clones are male.
With the masks?
Yes.
I think they're fantastic,
yes,
yeah.
Yes.
It's a shame you don't sell the masks, because I think they're great.
Well, maybe one day soon. You know, have to do, can't do everything at one time, but probably in the near future. It's been really a style that's just evolved, that's more using fashion as entertainment, as is really what we're doing. Mm. And it's theater also involved, because this is what I really love, the theater, and I studied acting and all of this, and I just couldn't do a singing career without doing the visuals really in that direction, and fooling the people with a sense of humor. And for example, here you would never guess that I was pregnant in both these shots.
Have a look down here.
I was about 6 months pregnant or something.
And these are incredible. I mean, so these are in fact maternity dresses. And if you said to somebody, here's some maternity dresses, and they'd say, oh, I think that's amazing, isn't it? I mean, it's just
I had to do a performance in this one. We had a sort of a baby shower party where Debbie Harry was the host and everything.
The other thing is that you're the only person really who could wear these things and make them
I think so. I think they look, you know, that's what's actually great about, that's what I enjoy, is that I am different and I'm the only one really that can sort of get away with this stuff.
Mm. Do you have any plans to go into films at all, or
Last year I got about 3 offers to do films. Blade Runner was one, which I turned down because Ridley Scott wanted a reply too quickly before I even read the script, a couple other things. There's something else going on in Hollywood called Flash Dance or something. They wanted me to play some strange character. But I haven't found anything as interesting. But there is an interesting offer coming in from Australia, which is supposed to start filming next year, February.
What would that be about?
Well, it's about my relationship with a young white fella who's younger than I am. I'm an African from Somalia, something like that. But it's quite mysterious. I supposedly have some strange connection with dolphins, and there's like an affair between myself, the young man, and the dolphin.
Grace Jones at home? I mean, is there a Grace Jones at home who sits and watches the telly and drinks a cup of coffee?
I drink a little bit of wine, you know, or scotch or something like that. I love watching films on television. I buy a lot of videos myself, classic ones that I think are very, that have a lot to gain. I have a child. Jean-Paul and myself, we have a child who's quite amusing, and there's a lot to learn from him also. So I spend a bit of time with him, and I love, you know, listening to music, and I go to the gym, and I do shopping. But I spend a lot of time just,
don't feel
good.
Don't people come up and bother you if you go shopping and things?
Sure they do, you know, and if I feel in the mood for it, it's okay, you know, I'm nice and pleasant. And if I'm aggravated or something, if I'm in a hurry, then I just simply say I'm in a hurry and I can't talk right
growl
now.
Growl at them.
Yeah, I gotta, you know, get out of there. I don't growl at them.
Walking down the street.
Kicking cans. Looking at the billboard. The also-rans. Summing up the people. Checking out the race. Doing what I'm doing. Feeling out of place. Walking in the rain. Feeling like a woman, looking like a man, sounding like a no-no, mating when I can, whistling in the darkness, shining in the night, coming to the conclusion, night is right, it's tight, walking in the rain. Come in all you jesters, enter all you fools. Sit down, no-no, ogre ghouls. Trip the light, fantastic. Dance the swivel hips. Coming the conclusion, button up your lips. Walking in the rain. Walking in the rain. I just like the feeling of life. And living as hard as I can, as in the song Living My Life, which we did also a video to. I mean, I really mean that. I think I feel very much like living very hard, very strong, and doing as much as I can. I don't like being quiet for too long. I think being quiet, just enough time to regenerate, not to burn myself out, is important.
They're very, very good, actually. This is, we're very proud of all those
great
boys. Yeah. How was the concert? Okay?
Whew.
Good?
I almost took my clothes off. If I had one more night, maybe.
Is that right? What is it? They encourage you to take your clothes off, don't they?
Well, let me tell you, I get to feeling so powerful up there, so strong, and they give me such energy back, you know, that it just leaves me, like you say, you know, do whatever. Do what you want with me.
Nobody ever said that to me in my whole life. What about that? You were supposed to be here last Thursday.
Well, don't talk about it. I'll tell
what
you.
Happened?
No,
happened?
I will talk about it. I'll talk about it. It's the airline's fault, really. You know.
Well, we don't have
it's
to
It's worse than riding the Greyhound bus.
Is that right?
Yes.
What was wrong with the airline?
Well, you get there 10 minutes before and they tell you you can't get on the plane. You know. I mean, the car broke down. I had battery trouble with the car. And I got there 10 minutes before. The plane was still at the gate. And they said, we're sorry, but, you know, 20 minutes before, I'm sitting there with $20,000 in airplane tickets. And you can't get on. I mean,
that's for
imagine?
All the people that were with you, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they wouldn't let you on.
I've got $20,000 worth of airplane tickets.
Yeah.
You know?
And they still said no.
And they still said no.
You know why? It's the computers now. The computers lock off. At 10 minutes to flight time, the computers lock off and they can't change
well,
it. That's it.
I think they should have some kind of system where
humans.
For an emergency in that situation, you know. Yeah. They used to be a lot more generous.
Hmm.
You know, they've really gotten...
Well, the trouble is, I think when the computer locks off now, they don't have much to do about it. Let me talk about Grace Jones. I really want to find out about you. You've got this cult following you've got. They said that the people that follow you are fashion designers and artists and all of that, but it seems to be coming more public now than just the...
Well, they're the public, too, you know?
Well, I know that, but I mean, it's sort of a confined group, aren't they? You know?
Well, I think it's spreading. You know, I think that growth is necessary, you know? I've been working very hard also to grow, and as I grow, my public is growing, and I think that's fantastic.
What about as a child? Now, you didn't have ambitions along these lines as a child. Your father was, what, a minister? Or?
Yes, but that didn't make me want to be a minister.
No.
No. As a matter of fact, they said I'd never marry a minister. No. Yeah. You know, it's difficult having a father as a minister because you always have to set the example.
Right.
You know, that's awful. That's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
And you're not being paid for it.
And when did you decide about the modeling career?
Well, that happened after I started acting a bit. And it was just very slow in the acting business. There wasn't any work, you know. And I just decided to be a model and do acting on the side. And modeling, I went to Paris, and in 3 months I was a top model.
Mm.
You know, I think they like different faces there, you know.
Yeah. Well, yeah. So, of course, everything obviously evolutionized and moved on from being a model onto being a performer on stage, yes, and stuff. But everything is so different and so outrageous. Who creates all these ideas? Like, can we see your hairdo?
No, I'm sorry. You have to wait for that.
Oh, I can't see the hairdo yet.
Not yet, no.
Oh,
that's
okay.
A surprise.
Okay, well, I'll hang in there. I don't know.
Yeah. You see that, you know, later on in the performance.
Okay. Well, who invented the hairstyle? Who did all
that? I started always with my hair short. I think I dyed my hair once, and it all fell out.
Is that right?
Yes, I dyed it blonde, and everything fell out. So I shaved my head after that. And after that, I decided this was great. It was the perfect hairdo for me.
Yeah.
It shows my face. I could carry it. You know, everything else was a distraction.
Uh-huh.
I wear hats better. I can wear anything on my head. It doesn't lump up here and lump up there.
Mm-hmm.
And I decided to keep this hairdo, and I just experimented with it short.
Mm.
So the look just sort of developed, you know, and I work along with Jean-Paul Gould, who's my husband, and
but there's a lot of debate about
that.
In the papers, that you say he is your husband and he isn't your husband.
Well, he is and he isn't.
What do you mean? Are you married?
I am and I'm not.
You have a child by him?
Yes.
But you're not sure if you're married?
No. Sometimes, yes. Sometimes, no. Really? That's just that's the way it is.
Well, it's okay, I guess. If it fits, it's fine. Yeah, it doesn't matter to me. It's all right. And what is this about you punch the television compere in England?
Well, tell me more about it.
Well, I don't know. I heard I read a story that said that you got annoyed with a television interviewer in England.
Well, I think he got annoyed with me first, and that was my reaction.
What'd you do?
You know, well, I hit him. Like, you want me to show?
No. I don't want to.
Well, you asked me what did I do. I'm just showing you.
Oh, all right.
I'm going to demonstrate.
She carries this act all around with her.
No, you're not. You're sweet.
I read a quote. You once said that you were that you look better dressed as a man than you do as a woman.
Well, don't you think so?
Well, I don't know. Is this your...
Well, the thing is, you know, I mean, I can't come out like Marilyn Monroe with tits and ass because I haven't got any.
Neither do I, but I don't walk around dressed like...
No, but I think if a woman's going to look, you know, voluptuous and all of that, then she's got to sort of be round and, you know, plump, like a peach or something.
Yeah.
And I'm built more sort of lean, like a horse.
You know? Right.
So...
Built for speed.
Yeah.
Right, yeah. What about this involvement with the audience now? Do you actually go out to the audience and tell them to do with you as they wish?
Well, sometimes I just go, you know, like that.
And what do they do?
They touch me everywhere. Get hands all over.
Has anybody ever gotten carried away with all of that?
Well, isn't that big? That's already carried away. What more do you want? You know, we can't have sex right there or anything.
No, you wouldn't want to do that on stage. No,
no, but, you know, they
Where do you
their
do that,
fingers, you know, in places.
Yeah, okay.
Changing the subject.
Yes, yes. This is what is known as segue to the dates. That's what it's called. You're going to do this number now. This is your newest hit, isn't it?
No, actually, I'm a little bit upset because, well, this song is from Warm Leatherette, which was...
The album before this song.
Right. But I'm happy that it's re-showing up, whatever.
Re-emerged.
Yes, on the charts. So it's one of my favorite songs anyway.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm going to do.
Okay. Well, why don't you go over there and get ready? And then I can walk in and say goodbye to you when you finish the number two. I'll give you a hug or something and say hello. And then we'll throw you with our audience to see what happens.
Okay.
Right. You go out there and I'll tell them where you are. All right?
Okay.
Okay.
Can I take a little...
Yeah. Take that with you. Give it to somebody over there. Grace Jones has a concert. She's in Adelaide, May the 5th, Sydney, May the 8th, and they've just added, by public demand, another concert on May the 9th in Sydney. She's in Brisbane on the 11th of May, Newcastle the 14th of May, then back to Sydney the 16th through the 19th of May. And as I said, there's an extra concert in Sydney on May the 9th. With the lights, the music, and all the things that she does, it is a spectacular performance that Grace Jones gives. She is doing this song, which was the big hit off of her previous album, as she said. So would you please greet her now? Ladies and gentlemen, Grace Jones. Here. Yeah, right.
Not my concern. I'm very superficial. I hate everything official. Made a desperate appeal, now save your breath. Attachment to obligation, that's so wet. And your sex life complications are not my fascination. Private life, come on, baby, leave me out.
Private life, come on, baby, leave me out. find that you frighten men?
Of course it frightens them, definitely, because, you know, it's like they've met their match kind of thing, you know? I mean, I've let the male side of me really, I've experienced it and I've allowed it to grow.
How did
so that I can deal with a man to man, you know?
Mm. Most women wouldn't deal with men man to man, they deal woman to man. How do the feminists?
Well, that's the mistake.
Yeah. How do the feminists feel about you? Do they?
I have no idea. You know, I'm not into politics really. Only, I mean, my own politics that has to do with me individually, which is awfully selfish, actually.
What you're saying is that women should assert themselves physically, yes, as well as verbally. Well.
Definitely. Oh, yeah.
Would you ever be domesticated, do you think? Would you ever play the role of the housewife?
What is the role of the housewife? Housewife of 1930 or 1920 or 19...
Point.
I mean, I don't know. I don't think I could play those housewives. I don't know what they were. I play the housewife I play now. I don't know if it's what your housewife is or anyone else's, but...
Mm. It's an unlikely... If I may say so, background for a lady who does show aggression, that your father was a preacher.
Oh, well, yes, you have to be aggressive to be a preacher.
Yeah.
Oh, of course, you have to get up there on a pulpit or stage, whatever you choose to call it, and, you know, have everybody sitting there completely indoctrinated and believing your interpretation. And I think that takes a lot of aggression to do that. But, I mean, you know, you could do it. Charming aggression, there's, you know, different types. Mm. But I think I definitely got a gift from being on stage and performing, actually, from my father, even though he doesn't know it.
You started as a model, is that right?
And well, then... that's what the press says.
Well,
anyway.
What did you start as?
I started as a school teacher. I laugh because I just imagine myself being in school right at this moment teaching a class.
You'd have their attention, I promise you.
No, I did. I started as a school teacher and then I went into drama. So I actually started acting before anything else. And I've just sort of completed the cycle.
And then you went into singing. Remember those startling LPs Maudling that you made a couple of years
singing.
Ago?
Yeah. I'm still into singing. It's gone into my blood and I'm just not able to get it out of my blood. I'm addicted to music. I mean, Wilt Chamberlain will tell you. I mean, I drove him crazy on the set. He wouldn't come into the makeup room unless I turned off my ghetto blaster. That's a, you know, a Sony,
yes,
portable.
Well, thing. You'll probably get a free one now. This is all. Are you very fit? Do you go in for bodybuilding?
Yeah, I certainly do. I love bodybuilding. It's great. Mm. It's really great. The machines are so beautiful, some of them. And they're all sort of black and shiny, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
And anyway, it's a way of letting out one's aggressions, too. Because I don't always get...
Have you got a lot of aggression?
Oh, of course I do!
What brings it on? Silly questions.
You know, long days. No. No. You know, long days, bad news on the news on television. I mean, all
but you're a believer
violent
in...
movies. That brings on.
But you believe
aggression.
In letting it go.
Definitely. I would be dead now if I didn't.